pecan pie is a Thanksgiving classic, and today we're making it even more memorable by baking a layer of rich chocolate beneath the traditional spiced pecan filling. Oh my goodness, Debbie. When I say we're making it even better, I really mean you.
I'm gonna make it, you're gonna eat it.
That's right.
You guys at home are gonna eat it as well. This is so easy to make and so delicious. And it just sort of elevates it and kicks it up a notch.
It sort of elevates it.
Well, yeah, it's a little bit of a departure, so it's not so, I love pecan pie, don't get me wrong, but I just think it makes it a little bit better.
I think you're right. I think everybody that will taste it will agree with you right now. Now, we're starting with a little, what you call a blind or a par bake of the crust.
Yes, exactly. Store-bought crust is absolutely fine.
Okay.
What you're gonna do is, you're gonna put it in your pie dish and you're gonna bake it at about 425 for 7 minutes. You're just par baking or blind baking it, same thing. And you're doing that because you want the crust to get a little, you just want it to brown a tiny bit and just to get it a little crispy because you're gonna put all of the mixture inside, and you don't want it to be soggy at the bottom. No
okay,
one's gonna
good.
Like
I just had a little piece of that crust. And it's
and how good is that, right?
Oh my God, the spices in here are amazing.
So we're gonna leave that aside for a second. We are going to melt our chocolate. Very simple. Mm. Chocolate chips, whatever flavor chocolate chips you like. You want dark chocolate, you want semi-sweet, whatever it is that floats your boat. Now, you can do this in the microwave and make it even easier. You just put the chocolate chips with some milk or heavy cream or half and half in the microwave for about 30 seconds, get in there, stir it, and put it back in until it just melts completely. If you don't want to do that, you can do it on a stovetop in a saucepan. You don't even need a double boiler.
You don't?
No, all you need to do is just stay on it and keep it low so it doesn't burn. There you go. Okay. So now we take our chocolate and we are going to put it on the bottom.
So that's the
crust.
First thing that goes in. It's sort of like the bottom layer. I'm looking at this as it cuts through and you see the pecan filling and then you see the chocolate on the bottom.
It's really quite
yummy. Definitely tastes amazing here.
So now we're gonna do this and we are gonna spread this out.
Beautiful.
Just a thin layer. It doesn't have to be too thick because you're gonna put that yummy pecan pie filling inside.
Are you kidding me right now?
It's getting a little messy on the sides, but don't worry about it because we're gonna cover it anyway.
Yeah, absolutely.
There you go.
Beautiful.
So we got that. Now
it's the pecan filling. This is the star of the show, obviously.
Here
we go. And you got some great yumminess there. Are those just beaten eggs in there to start?
Just beaten eggs.
Okay.
I'm gonna add some sugar, very basic, very simple. Here we go, get that sugar in there.
And I understand that this next ingredient is the real, it's sort of like a must-have when you're making pecan pie.
You need dark corn syrup when you're making pecan pie. Otherwise, it's not gonna be, it's not gonna have that rich, deep flavor that the pecan pie has. You know, a lot of people think it's the pecans. It's not really the pecans, it's the corn syrup. Okay, so you want that dark, rich corn syrup. Then you're gonna put some melted butter in because everything's better with butter. A little bit of salt, because like we talk about so often here on the show, you really do need salt in baked goods. It really brightens it and kicks it up a notch. Delicious vanilla extract.
Okay.
I absolutely love vanilla extract, also a must. Some cinnamon.
I'm telling you right now,
some allspice.
Love the scent of cinnamon. Oh. It smells like Thanksgiving in here.
It really
does. Such a deep, warm sweetness, right? And it pairs really well with all sorts of different dishes, whether it's savory or sweet. Wouldn't you say, Deb?
1,000%. And you know, cinnamon is one of the oldest spices in the world.
I did not
know
that.
No joke. And vanilla, of course, is one of the most beloved flavors in the world. I just love it. And when I do my baking, I always use McCormick Pure Vanilla Extract. Well, because it's made from the finest quality imported vanilla beans. And when you're baking, you want to have the best vanilla beans, really.
No doubt about it. Vanilla adds such a sweet, rich, subtle flavor to the pie. It's incredible, Deb.
So
really
good.
Great.
All right, so I have mixed it all together here. My goodness, that smells fantastic.
Mm, tastes even
better. So now this is all we do.
All right.
We just pour it in. And then we put our pecans on top.
You gotta have those pecans right on top.
That's right.
Look at that.
Oh,
that's the gooiness.
That's
the pecan pie has such a unique kind of texture to it. You know what I mean? It's so good.
There's really nothing like pecan pie.
Isn't.
Unless it's chocolate pecan pie.
Well done.
That's why I put this around.
You're gonna bake this now. What temperature and about how long, Deb?
325, 55 to 60 minutes. Everybody knows their ovens. We talk about this quite a bit. But what you wanna do is you wanna make sure that you watch the baking process, because what happens many times, the crust will start to get too brown and you don't want it to burn. So what you'll do is you'll get a little bit of foil and you'll put like a foil ring around it like
I
this.
I love this trick.
Yeah, this is a great one.
And this because the crust has already been sort of blind baked, has already been baked a little bit, is that?
Yes.
Okay.
And because the rest of the crust is covered, you know, so it's not going to, this may burn and So I usually do it at about 30 minutes.
Okay.
Again, just watch. Just watch and see.
Oh, so you can start it without it and
start
then add
it, without it
if it starts to get brown.
That's, yeah, you need it to bake a little more. But at about 30 minutes, I put it on. Put that in the oven, 325, 55 to 60 minutes. And then guess what comes out?
And then you get to enjoy.
Ta-da!
Go ahead, cut yourself a piece. You're going to freak out. This
How
is so good.
How beautiful is that, you
oh
guys?
Gosh, it's delicious. To find more ways to use spices in your cooking, visit McCormick.com and then head over to HallmarkChannel.com for this perfectly decadent pie recipe. I mean, so great for the holidays, everybody.
Look at that. Oh, I'm going in.